Following the Ethereum 2.0 ETH 2.0 deposit contract launch announcement yesterday, 3.62% of the needed ETH has been already staked in the contract, while some are questioning how smart is it to lock away ETH 32,12,808 United States dollars for years. Fueled by the news, ETH rallied from 383 United States dollars to over 406 United States dollars and is now correcting its gains, trading at 399 United States dollars 10:43 Coordinated Universal Time. The price is up by almost 5% in a day and 3% in a week. Additionally, per bitinfocharts.com, active addresses 7-day simple moving average went up 6.9% in a week to 590,123. In the same period, the number of ETH sent from addresses increased by 7.3%. As reported yesterday, the first phase of ETH 2.0, Phase 0, finally got a specific launch date. The developers announced that the Genesis block of the so-called Beacon Chain is expected on December 1st at the earliest. With the first phase, users will be able to earn rewards by locking up their ETH in the deposit contract, and by acting as active or passive validators. This deposit contract, said to be one of the final steps before Phase 0, also relevant as it will enable ETH transactions between Ethereum and ETH 2.0 is now live. For the ETH 2.0 launchpad, there are currently 18,981 ETH already staked and counting. This means that some ETH 505,300 more is needed for the mainnet to be launched. Developers have also been warning users not to send their ETH to the deposit contract, as this will result in a failed transaction, and does not mean you are staking on ETH 2.0. The launchpad must be used instead. However, Phase 0 will come only after there is enough ETH locked up in the smart contract, and this will then remain locked there for a couple of years. Still, there are those questioning how smart it is to put some 12,800 United States dollars per current prices locked away in a contract for years, not being able to use it when you want to. My crypto CEO Taylor Monahan asked this question, and at least per this survey, most of the respondents would not opt for this. RitKaiApp founder Lefteris Karapetses argued that locking USD is different than locking ETH, as the latter could moon in the meantime, and the owner would lose the chance to cash in at least partially. For others, this is not a problem if the person has more ETH on the side. Additionally, Monahan argued that there's no way out to correct if the yields go too low. CryptoTesters founder Emmanuel Cohen noted that some people are reportedly suggesting to wait before staking in ETH2 to see how yields will turn out, adding that if yields are low, the opportunity cost of having your ETH locked up for a year might not be worthwhile. But this might put into question the launch of the Beacon Chain. Still, many seem to agree that the threshold of staked ETH needed for Phase 0 launch will be reached, but others, like Karapetses, are wondering more about how far after the threshold it will go and what APR annual percentage rate will that mean for your locked ETH.